Shalom, I'm standing outside the home and studio of Dov Lederberg and Yael Avi-Yonah. And today we're going to take a look at some of the works of Dov Lederberg. So come on, let's take a look.
Welcome to our hacienda, our studio, our home. We are working very intensively in what we call Jewish art, but we're using modern forms. One of the areas which I've worked out in the past very intensively has been the Hebrew letters, particularly the scribal letters as they're seen in the Torah, which is one of the basic forms, motivating forms in Judaism itself. And here the idea is what we call the creation of the world from the letters themselves. It's an idea of Yesh Me'ayin, that the letters themselves became the basis of all reality, as they were uttered by God, and every utterance was internal. Another area which I'm involved with is the idea of communication. And I have a series, this is one of a series which I call dialogues. Here you have what you could call the idea of forms relating to each other.
But these are like two forms are connected.
Are trying to connect. Here actually the experience is one of anger. There's another work which is using almost the same stance, the same form, template, but here you have like a connection of love and tenderness between two people. So I'm constantly searching, being impacted by my studies in Hasidus and Kabbalah, and finding through an intuitive process the forms that will convey what I would call spiritual ideas. The ram that was used in place of Isaac, the one of the horns was heard at the time of the Har Sinai, and the other horn will be heard when the Messiah will come. The idea of prayer itself is an idea of what I call Sulam Yaakov, the ladder of Jacob, which is a paradigm for prayer. You're always striving to go to a higher and higher rung. So here's like an endless process of soaring, of going higher and higher, and this is what I'm trying to convey in my work. My wife and I work, we call ourselves art inspired by science and Kabbalah. That is to say, and we find there may be a meeting ground between these two areas, and living in Eretz Israel is very important for us as a source of inspiration and bringing us to a higher and higher level.
For Israeli Salad in Jerusalem, this is Mark Kaplan for Israel National News.
What does the Western Wall mean to you?
The Kotel is Israel to me, and it makes me feel amazing, and it's emotional, and just, it's great.
Okay, welcome back. We now continue with Mark's tour through the world of Israeli Jewish art. Today, Mark Kaplan meets Yael Avi-Yonah from Jerusalem, who uses Kabbalistic themes in her artwork.
Shalom, we are once again at the home and studios of artists Dov Lederberg and Yael Avi-Yonah. Last time we took a look at some of the works of Dov Lederberg, and today we're going to take a look at some of the works of his wife, Yael. So let's take a look.
Here you see an anaglyphic painting, kinetic, of the angel Michael, part of a series of the four major angels. Michael is described as the water element, and that's why you see as if you're throwing a pebble into the water. You see the lion.
The ripple
and
effect?
The ripple effect. Yeah, you see. If I'm turning it fast, you actually don't see any detail. You just see really throwing the pebble, and the ripples are coming to you, going into inside water. And when it slowed down a bit, you suddenly see the other element, the right hand. He's one of the rotating swords, so the rotating sword inside, and the right hand of God. In my right is Michael, in my left. And the same effect is in the other end, the other angels. Another painting that is also based on giving ideas through visual is Jerusalem at the time of the Messiah. It's a square city. In the middle is the stone that the whole world is based on it, like a core of an atom. And all the other nations, they will be separate. They'll come to the same temple, but on different area. That stone, if you turn it very fast, everything diminishes, only the stone as a core remain. And here is the new attitude to mine, through light to show the beauty of praying and of praying for Jerusalem at the time of the Messiah. So this is a young girl, she's praying and she's concentrating when the light is coming out, that's the praying, like wing. Being born in Jerusalem and being a daughter of archaeologists who did the model of Jerusalem at the second temple, I always laugh and say, I will be the expert on the third temple, hopefully. This is a vision I had for many years, as if you are standing on the Mount of Olives and the river of life already occur, and the city appears reflecting in the river when the tree of life is coming through, actually the Mizbeach, and you have the DNA coming down, life is coming out, the tree of life. This is actually Shaar HaRachamim, where hopefully all the resurrection will come, and I'm preparing the gate. Even the foundation of Jerusalem at the time of the Messiah will be made of precious stones. And this is again the river, the floating city, floating on the rivers of life. What frightened me, that letters appear in the text, in the canvas that I did not paint.
But these letters were not intentional. You didn't paint those.
I did not paint it. You see, did not paint it. It comes here, it's like a line. I don't know what is written. It's emulsion that comes from two different materials, oil and acrylic. When they work together, create some kind of effect. Here is the beginning, is the end. The painting like that, it's like the egg divided the three shrine and then the four upper. Jerusalem at the time of the Messiah, upper Garden of Eden, and you'll have like letters inside. I don't know if you can see the cute Kabbalah and the bird. But these are not even symbols. These are just expression of form to make people feel that things are happening, that things will come, and that's my goal.